Hi everyone, today we're going to be doing a mani using the Daizie acrylic and dipping powders. These powders are really awesome. You can use them two ways, as an acrylic system or you can use them as dipping. Today I am going to be using them as dipping powders. These are the five beautiful colors. The first one is going to be from the Disco Reflective collection and it has some hints of blue glitter. Wisteria is from the Pastel Spring Chalk collection. Bronco is from the Brown Nude collection. And then Onahau is also from the Pastel Chalk collection. And then we have Sandal, which I love Sandal from the Brown Nude collection. Here are all the four colors. And then the glitter one right there is amazing. These colors were really hard to pick what one I was going to do my mani with. I ended up using three colors. So first step here, you can see I'm going in with my Risen Legacy Nail Cleaner. I just like to go over all my nails with that to get all the oils off my nails. And then here, I still do like to use the Prep and Bond just in case I have any growth from either my builder gel or my jelly tips. I just prefer to use that step. It's optional, you don't have to, but I do prefer to use that step before I start my dipping process. I do like to use peel base. This peel base here, I'm using the UNT peel base. Now, peel base is very tricky. It did take me a really long time to figure out what the best method was going to be for me. I choose to do two full layers of the peel base just to ensure that I can get it off. I don't really like prying on my natural nails, so the two layers definitely works best for me for an easy peel off. Sometimes if I want my nails to last longer, I'll just do, you know, one full layer, but I do prefer to use two. So here we are going in with the first step. I am using all Risen Legacy nail liquids here. We are using the first one, it's Onahau, and that is from the Pastel Chalk Collection. I love this color. It is not your normal pastel blue. It is like the name says. It's a chalky light blue, and it's so pretty. It's like has more white to it than your normal pastel blue, which I really like that a lot. So right now I am doing all the solid colors first, and then I'm going to go ahead and then do glitter on an accent nail. I'm going to be using the Disco Reflective Collection Glitter, the mixed blue one. So I'm going to go ahead and let you watch right now me doing my nails, and I will pop back in a little bit. so now I'm going to go ahead and encapsulate my nails with Pure Diamond. It is Risen Legacy's clear dip powder. And I like to clear cap all my nails before filing and buffing. And I like to do this step as well before I use any glitters. So after I do the dip in the clear, I'm going to go ahead and activate just to ensure that I don't get any other glitter on nails that I don't want to be sparkly. So I'm going to go ahead and let you watch this, and I'll be back in a few minutes. I'm going in and activating all my nails before we go in with that glitter. And you can see there, I do use a different base liquid for glitters. There's a G in the cap there. I just want to make sure that when I'm using solids, I don't get any glitter in my solid colors. And check out this glitter. That is one dip, and it is so sparkly and so pretty. The glitters are super fine in this reflective glitter and super easy to work with. And it is just so pretty. And when you see it in the sunlight, it's like way prettier in person. Like, the camera does not do it justice at all. When I was done with this mani, I was like, I totally need to do a mani with all glitter. So I did end up doing a mani just of this glitter alone, and it was stunning. And what I'll do is I'll leave a picture of that mani at the end of the video. So right now I'm going to go ahead and encapsulate that sparkly, gorgeous nail. I do use a different clear powder when I'm dipping into glitters. And this glitter is amazing. I cannot stop looking at it. If you do not have any reflective glitters, this was like my first time playing with a reflective glitter. I'm telling you, it is life changing. Like, I could not stop staring at that one nail after I got done with the mani. So I went ahead and did my filing and buffing off camera. And I went in again with my Risen Legacy nail cleaner just to get all that filing dust off, but before I go ahead and activate again. So I am going to go ahead and activate. Let that dry for 2 minutes, go ahead, wipe it off, and then go in with my top coat. All right, so I'm just using a lint-free wipe to remove any extra activator on the nails before I go in with my top coat. And the first layer of top coat, I'm gonna go in with three quick strokes on the nail, and then I'm going to go ahead and wipe off my brush to prevent any hardening. And then the second time around, I'll go ahead and do a more detailed top coat. Just wrapping up the top coat here on the last couple nails. I really like how this mani turned out. I love the color combination, and that reflective glitter is amazing. So definitely go ahead and check out Daizie's Creative Shop on Etsy for more awesome colors, and check out those reflective glitters. And I'll see you in my next video. Thanks.